Now we will see the extension and the contraction of demand. What do you mean by extension? That means expanding. Contraction, shrinking. So how the demand will be expand or contract due to only the concept of price. So the extension and the contraction of demand is caused only due to the changes in the price. Changes in price. Due to the changes in the price, if there is a changes in the demand, either the extension or contraction, we are going to see. If the demand increase because of changes in price, it is called extension. If the demand decrease because of the changes in price, is called contraction. So how will you draw the diagram? Let us see the diagram of a demand. X-axis, y-axis, here quality of demand, quantity demanded, here price. So in the x-axis, we have marked the quantity demanded, in the y-axis, I have marked price. Usually, the demand curve height will be left from left to right, downward sloping, I told. Due to price, we are going to see now. If the price is OP, this is a demand curve. If the price is OP, the demand is OM. The price is OP, the demand is OM. Now, the price has increased to OP1. Now the price has increased to from OP to OP1. What will be the demand? Demand has decreased from OM to OM1. So the increase in the prices brings the decrease in the demand. This is called contraction. You understand, girls? The increase in the price bring the decrease in the demand is called contraction. Now, the price is decreasing from OP to OP2. Now, what would be the demand? Now, the demand is OM2. So, if the price decrease, the demand increase. So, when the demand is changing, only because of price, it is called extension or contraction. Both can be happen because of the changes in price based on the commodity needed or required. Do you understand? This is extension or contraction of demand. Now let us see shift in demand. The next one is shift in demand. In demand curve. There in the extension or the contraction, we said that only because of the changes in the price, the extension or the contraction happens. But here, the shift happens not because of the price, but because of the other things. I already told you in economics, what are all the other things? Taste, income, preference, rate of substitute goods, all the things are called other things which bring changes in the demand, isn't it? So, if there is no changes in the price, but there is a change in the taste, income, either the taste or income, or preference or substitute, there will be a changes in the demand. Then how the demand curve will be? Now, let us see the shifting demand curve. O, x-axis, y-axis, here quantity demanded, here price. As I said, here subtraction, prices will be changes. Here, price will not change. No changes in price. Then how the price curve will be? If there is no changes in the price, how the price curve will be? Price curve or demand curve will be like this. This is the curve P. So, here in the shift in demand curve, the price will never change. Instead, the things changes in the things like taste, income and preference substitute bring changes in the demand. That is called shift in demand curve. Now, D is the demand curve. Here, OM is the quantity demanded. The price is not changed, so it is a horizontal line, inelastic. So, there is no changes in the price. But because of the changes in the taste and income, preference and substitute goods, there is a change in the demand curve, that is D1. So, what would be the demand? M1. This is shift leftward shifting. Either it can move along in the price curve towards rightward shifting also because of the changes in the date, taste and sometimes the demand may be increased. So, both are possible. The OM is the normal. Because of the changes in the taste, income, preference and the price of the substitute good, either the demand can be shrink or the demand can be increased. So, this is called shifting demand curve. In the shifting demand curve, the price doesn't change. Changes in the taste, income only bring changes in the demand. Do you understand what is extension contraction and what is shift in demand? The extension contraction only changes in the price, bring changes in the demand. There, price doesn't bring any changes, but other things bring changes in the demand. Do you understand, girls? Next one, elasticity of demand. What do you mean by elasticity? Movement, that is elasticity. The law of demand tells changes in the demand due to price, isn't it? Because of the changes in the price, how the demand is changing. That is law of demand. If the price increase, the demand decrease. If the price decrease, the demand increase. That is law of demand. So, the law of demand determines that the price changes. Because of the changes in the price, there will be a change in the demand. But they fail to say how much the demand is increasing or decreasing. Isn't it? The law of demand, it doesn't explain how much the demand is increasing, how much the demand is decreasing. It doesn't. So it fails to explain the increase in demand and decrease in demand. How much rate is increasing. So, the economists, they have find a technical term, elasticity of demand, which gives the explanation, the rate of changes in the quantity due to change in price. So, the elasticity of demand explains the rate of changes in the quantity due to the change in price. So, elasticity or more elasticity demand means more or elasticity demand. What do you mean by this more elasticity? A small changes in the price bring big changes in the demand. That is more elasticity. Small changes in the price brings large changes in the demand. It's called more elasticity demand. So, this gives the rate of changes in the quantity because of price. Because a small change, only a little amount of price increase, bring a large amount of increase, decrease in the demand or increase in the demand. If there is a small decrease in the price, small decrease in the price, brings large increase in the demand. Yes, elasticity or more elasticity of demand. Here we have so many types of the elasticity, equal to 1, less than 1, more than 1, more than 6 types of, there are 6 types of elasticity of demand are there, that we will see in the next video.